So Toni Storm is gone from the WWE. As of me talking, we don't exactly know what went down, but it certainly sounds like Toni decided it wasn't for her, so left, got her release, and that was that. It is going to be an interesting fallout. It does mean there's a few things World Wrestling Entertainment would like you to erase from your brain, and that's what we shall go through today. For I am Simon from What Culture, please do hit that subscribe button, and this is 10 things indeed WWE wants you to forget about Toni Storm. Number 10, they didn't make her a star. Which is ludicrous, as she basically came ready-made. By getting a microwave meal and throwing out the window, it is not going to work. All you need to do is talk to a Progress Wrestling fan or someone who watches Stardom, and they will tell you about Storm's plus points and how they thought as soon as she debuted on the main roster, that would be that. Zoom straight to the moon because look what she's already done. It probably means if Toni had avoided WWE altogether, she would have found her place within the industry, which doesn't look that great for WWE. They went the opposite way, and we will never understand why, although I suppose that is just what they do. Toni Storm had already made a name for herself before she started working for Vince McMahon, though, hence why she got the gig in the first place. So why you wouldn't capitalize on that, I will never know. Number 9, WWE missed the opportunities. And following on from that, let's talk about some specifics. Toni Storm won the Mae Young Classic at the 2018 Evolution pay-per-view. Triple H and Stephanie McMahon also came out and said that Storm was a future super-duper star, and when she finally did debut on SmackDown, Storm had all the coming soon treatment. Like, I know those videos went on too long, but whatever. Rather than use any of this, though, it took just a few weeks before Toni was treated like any other person, and all of this momentum was flushed down the toilet. It was nuts. It almost eliminates any surprise that she did leave, because she had the evidence to what was coming. I mean, go and listen to an interview she did a few months ago. She said she was sick and tired of sat in catering, and of course you would be. If you're a wrestler, you just want to wrestle. Number 8, the one note presentation. I don't get this, and why WWE thought this was enough, I will never know. But after she had made the jump from NXT, the big sell job was that Toni Storm's mum was really into 80s rock music, so was Toni Storm. I'm sorry, what? Poor Michael Cole had to spout this out every time she headed to the ring, like eventually it was going to work, whereas what was actually happening was fans waited to see some sort of progression, and it never came, and I bet eventually we would have just gone through Mrs. Storm's record collection. And look, I like 80s rock music, but what does that have to do with someone's quest to become a champion? You may as well say she's really into having lizards for pets, it has as much relevance. But this is what WWE hanged its hat on, and it was really stupid. At least mention what she did down in NXT, but of course we're not allowed to do that. The third brand owned by the promotion must be kept as some sort of weird magical secret. Number 7, she vanished for months. As hinted at earlier, after Storm had debuted on the 23rd of July 2021 SmackDown to defeat Zelina Vega, we didn't see her wrestle again until the 17th of September. I mean, seriously guys, what are we doing? Of course, that 2-month gap ruined any momentum, there's that word again, she did have, and fans barely remembered her because out of sight does mean out of mind. This once again makes no sense, as you have to go in hard with new recruits when they get to Mondays or Fridays, but WWE did the exact opposite. It's almost, dare I say it, like they hadn't actually constructed any long-term plans. It didn't help that when she was back, it was random tags with Liv Morgan with no explanation whatsoever, and as already stated, Toni was just another face when she should have been becoming the next big thing. Number 6, the gushing groupie. I mean, what on earth was this? Once again, no one told us what was happening, as I don't think they knew either, but for some reason, when Storm was back on SmackDown, she would find Dolph Ziggler and Bobby Roode and dance around with them. I don't know, you tell me. I suppose it was meant to be Dolphy Boy Blue trying to woo Toni, whereas she was more interested in Rick Boogs, but how silly does that sound? The answer, in case you don't know, is very, very silly. It was yet another situation which just ended one day, because why not? And this felt like I'd injected a bunch of drugs into my brain and then documented the effects. I mean, did it actually happen? It seemed it did, but I don't know why. Number 5, the Queen's Crown. We all know the Queen's Crown tournament wasn't exactly what it could have been. The whole thing went on for a grand total of 20 minutes, which was an insult to the women, really. I mean, they easily could have done more. The hope was when Toni Storm entered, she would be able to replicate her success from the Mae Young Classic, but instead she found herself in a rematch against Zelina Vega, who beat her in around about 120 seconds. So that was great. It kind of summed up how WWE saw her, because if they did have any major plans, at the very least they would have used the classic distraction roll-up finish. But no, this was as clear as day, and I I suppose they were just going to move on to whatever the hell was next, which in terms of this list is number 4, Dupi's Toady. I mentioned this on Ups and Downs at the time because I knew it wasn't going to work. It never does. But during the build to the Charlotte Flair Toni Storm title match, somebody decided that the hero challenger should have 2 pies thrown into her face and do the grand total of nothing in return. She was literally told to stand there, take it, and look a bit sad. My word. I know it sounds boring and old, but would Stone Cold Steve Austin ever have done this? No. The Rock? No. And there's nothing wrong with getting a dessert in the skull, but for goodness sake, go nuts, kick ass. Let this schmo know that you're not gonna take it. Fans like that, and I know this because I'm a fan. I know she got some revenge the following week when Toni did the same thing to Flair, but again, if you had snuck up on her, why wouldn't you beat the crap out of her? It was just so silly, once again, stupid silliness all over the place, and I would bet that Toni Storm didn't enjoy it much either. I mean, who wants to stand there with pie on their face and look like they about to cry? Number 3, Charlotte Rector. And following on from that, when we did get to the SmackDown Women's title match, Flair just ran through Toni Storm. And when Storm did get a victory, it was via the most devastating move in all of sports entertainment, the surprise roll-up. And we all know how that goes. It may as well be called a fluke. It's quite clear the entire time Toni had no chance and that she wasn't on Charlotte's level. Shockingly, this is exactly how it played out too. Flair ate her up, spat her out, probably leaving Storm once again to ponder what she was going to do next. And if the build had been better, we probably could have got away with this, but it was just there to do a title match and then move on to whatever was around the corner. Rubbish. Number 2, she asked for her release. Never let it be said any other way. It was Toni Storm who wanted out of WWE, and somehow she made it work, which was a surprise because usually it never does. Look at Neville now Pac, he was stuck there for years. The truth then is Storm looked at her prospects and decided she would rather wrestle elsewhere, which is quite damning all things considered, and also underlines how many opportunities there are out there right now. It's important. I don't think it's too much of a stretch to think that Toni may have been told there were no immediate plans for her now that the championship feud was done. And who wants to go and sit backstage waiting, especially when you're only 26? And I'm going to call it now. Hindsight will prove she made the right call. Number 1, how worrying all this is. There was a time where this would never have happened. WWE was the big dog and most would stay around and hope they eventually get used. So what Toni Storm's departure proved is that there is a whole new world out there for performers, and while that's awesome, what's not is that for some, WWE has become so difficult to navigate, they'd rather not be there at all. This should never be the way. I think it's fair to say that WWE didn't even try to make Toni a star, which is also not ideal. And if this keeps happening, who knows what the future looks like. Never forget too that we want all companies to operate at their best level. It's good for the wrestlers and it's good for us. And all of this has kind of shown that we're not quite there at the moment. Know of anything else that WWE wants you to forget about Toni Storm? Make sure you let us know in the comments below and don't forget to like the video, share the video, and subscribe. Then head over to whatculture.com where you can read articles like this. Make sure you come follow us on social media and we have a ton of videos. We made every single one just for you. Please go and watch one. My name is Simon from What Culture. Thank you for tuning in as always. Know that you are my favorite person ever. And when I see you, I'm going to give you a giant hug. You take care now and goodbye.